Well, Jim Millward is talking to the referee. I don't think he will be cheeking him or anything like that. No, Millward is too experienced a campaigner.
Well, is this to do a die off it from Hull? They've got to throw everything in here.
Is this the moment that can be saved? Down wide, remember, a try and a go. Will Farago through? Everyone on hand going in to help with the tackle. It's almost the last ditch chance for Hull. And there goes the whistle. There goes the whistle. Hull Kingston over to him. Never won the cup. Runners up three-time win. 10 points to 5.
Man has finally done it. He thoroughly deserves it. He took a terrible knock early on, and who would begrudge him this win?
Yeah, good little sport.
Well, extraordinary. Here is Steve Hubbard, the hero of the day. He's just come trembling down. If we can widen our shot just a little, we see that he's on his stretcher. How are you? What's the matter with your leg?
Well, I thought, you know, at first it was wrong, but it's just starting to feel a lot easier, and I just want to get up there with the lads.
Well, you're going to get some crutches, are you?
Somebody will lend me some crutches and I'll be straight up there.
Well, what about the try? I mean, you had a great, great day. 9 of the 10 points.
Yes, thoroughly enjoyed it. I knew it was going to be my day as soon as that, you know, that move came off. It was just fantastic. Unbelievable.
Well, Steve, we won't delay you any longer. Get your crutches and go up there and get your medal. Yeah. Bye-bye now. Eddie.
Well, it's drama, drama, and still drama. And there's the little man, Arthur Bunting. Himself a prisoner to scrum off. He'll be in tears, I imagine. No, it's a little Keith Epworth there.
Well, I think that was a great gesture, Eddie, coming from Keith Epworth. Two good scrummers.
Well, the final, I see, an emptying final here at Wembley, but this is one that we've talked about in many ways. Chances missed, chances taken, but sporting spirit by both of them. A great credit to Hull, for both teams from Hull, but being sporting to wish their defeat and the success are just the same. And Millward and Sullivan, who knows when they'll give up playing, we don't know. But there's Millward and Clive Sullivan, the two players I've been talking about. And Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth, the Queen Mother, I hope she's enjoyed it. She looks as if she's had, and she's having a word for him. To Roger, that is. He's trying not to let his emotions show, and that's a rare moment for him, a little smile on. And the Queen Mother's really been tremendous here with this first played for in 1897, the trophy of all trophies. Clive Sullivan, happy lad. John Millington just behind is David Watkin, son, showing David Hull. Well, there's Hubbard, Steve Hubbard, walking along with the physio. David Hall, Steve Hartley, Mike Smith, Brian Lockwood, the campaigner, and a lot of their mates in Australia. Well, Victor Bickfield, though, was doubtful a week ago, and here he is. First time ever, Roy Holstock, Glenn Casey, Charlie Watson, the chairman of Hull, and there he's going, Steve Hubbard, he's going up the stairs, he's going, the man who got the first try and then kicked two goals, who was worried about an ankle, it seemed to be, but it goes up to receive his award. And who wouldn't miss a moment like this? If he crawled upon his hands and knees, he'd do it. with the our royal guest, and he's don't know whether he's going to make it any further, but he'll go. Number two, Graham Bray. Naturally a sad team, but can get a smile, Charlie Birdsall. Ron the Wildman, Clyde Pickerel, young lad, plenty of time to win a medal, and a nice affectionate touch there, Vince Barra, and Paul Woods, and at the end of the queue comes, look, the concern, it's worth it all, he says. Well, lovely scenes, lovely moments. And a credit to both teams. And Roger riding high. Steve Hartley and Phil Hogan. I don't think Phil Hogan actually touched the ball, did he?
No, I don't think he did, but I don't think it matters now. But I'll tell you, Old Kingston and Hull have done credit to Rugby League, and I think it's a credit to Hull.
Yes. No doubt about that, it'll go down in the end. Len Casey, number 13. And they've gone. Hagar.
Kingston Rovers have won the rugby challenge.
Teams go on, the triumphs and the, I won't say failure, but happy man here, and Steve Hubbard, we don't know what his injury is, but at least he's going to have his moment of glory, just as the others have, and they're now at the corner of the stadium where the lot of the Hull Kingston Rovers fans, and the Lance Todd Trophy Award had been given to Brian Lockwood. Moments that by and large will never be repeated, so it's right that they get the most out of Brian Lockwood, the holding the cup in the middle there. Sure, he won't mind calling him a veteran. Steve Hartley. £1,555, and the players will be on at about £1,000 each. In the olden days it was set £3 for the winners and £2 for the losers. The progress of rugby league is at the end being occupied by Hull Kingston Rovers fans. There they are. A final that has had many moments that probably will never be repeated, and a wonderful presentation. And we hope to get somebody down there.